Hello everyone. I recently replaced the lead acid battery in my electric bike with a lithium battery. And these are the 5 lead acid batteries I removed from my old bike. They have been in use for 2 years and can only store a very limited amount of electricity. You can see that their internal resistance has increased significantly, up to 0.2 ohms. With this value, the batteries are nearly at the end of their lifespan. However, fortunately, with the device I'm sharing with you today, you can extend the battery's lifespan by up to 50%. This is especially beneficial for batteries used in cold regions, as cold weather significantly accelerates the reduction in battery lifespan. The device I'm sharing with you today is called a high-frequency desulfator. It generates high-voltage pulses with large currents, reaching hundreds of amps, lasting just a few microseconds. These high-voltage pulses cause the battery plates to oscillate and dissolve the lead sulfate crystals attached to them. These lead sulfate crystals are the main reason for your battery's reduced lifespan. The downside of this method is that you need to remove your battery and connect it to the desulfator device. You must not connect this device to a battery still installed in a car or inverter, as the high-voltage pulses could damage your vehicle or other equipment. Additionally, the desulfation process may take several weeks. Despite these drawbacks, this is truly an excellent device for recycling old batteries. I am sharing all the files of this project. It is an open source project that includes the Gerber files, C code files, PCB design files created with Eagle software, and the hex code files for you to upload to the microcontroller. Visit jlcpcb.com and upload the Gerber file I've shared. The PCB for this project is quite small and will cost you only $2 for 5 PCBs plus $2.65 for shipping fees. Additionally, if you collect discount coupons, the cost will be even lower. Moreover, JLCPCB offers a multicolor silkscreen service. Multicolor silkscreen, also known as full-color silkscreen PCBs, is a groundbreaking printing technique in PCB manufacturing. While traditional silkscreen designs were limited to single colors like white or black, multicolor silkscreen allows you to include intricate designs, vibrant graphics, logos, and even images on your PCB. JLCPCB currently offers a $10 discount coupon for this service. Don't miss out. Act quickly. Very soon after placing my order, I received my PCBs, which took about a week. If you want faster delivery, you can use DHL's service, though it is significantly more expensive. The PCBs are excellent as always, absolutely satisfied. This project uses relatively few components. You can take advantage of JLCPCB's PCBA service. They have an extensive component library that meets all your electronic component needs at very affordable prices. Alternatively, you can hand solder the components if you already have them available. This is the filter capacitor. You must use a capacitor with a voltage rating greater than 25 volts and low internal resistance. The capacitor I used is 1000 microfarads with an ESR of only about 16 milliohms. I measured it using a homemade LC meter, and you can find this project in one of my previous videos. You will also need a MOSFET with a voltage rating of around 100 volts and 2 diodes. For this project, I used an IF4110 MOSFET and 2 20-AS 80-volt diodes. You can also use equivalent components, as they will work just as well. There are two inductors here. One functions as a filter inductor, and the other serves as a boost inductor. You can find details about how the circuit works in the PCB files I've shared. I used an amorphous core for the filter inductor and an iron powder core for the boost inductor. Alternatively, you can use inductors from AX power supplies, and they will work well too. After soldering the circuit, connect it to two alligator clips using two wires about 20 centimeters long. Then, simply clip the circuit to the battery you want to repair. After some time, you will notice a significant improvement in the battery's performance. Here, after about 1 week of desulfation, the battery's internal resistance dropped to 100 milliohms, which is close to the 70 milliohms of a new battery. The results are excellent. Here, I connected the circuit's output to an oscilloscope. You can see that it generates numerous high-voltage pulses, reaching up to 30 volts and feeds them back into the battery. The frequency of these pulses is in the ultrasonic range, providing a strong desulfation effect. Thank you for watching my video, and see you in my future projects.